Kusumawardana and Rambitan against the reigning world champions Aaron Chia and Sony. Well, we lost four seeds in the second round of the men's doubles, which meant we only had four seeds at quarterfinal stage. And at quarterfinal stage, we knew we'd have a new name on the trophy because none of the pairs at quarterfinal had contested a final here at the Indonesian Open previously. So the Indonesian pair announced into the Istora Stadium. And a terrific quarterfinal win yesterday. The Malaysians, the reigning world champions, on a quest to win the first ever World Tour title. They've contested three finals previously, all at Super 500 level or above. In fact, all at 750 level and above. And I can tell you this will be a fourth meeting between these two pairs. And of the previous two, well, Aaron Chia and Sowi from Malaysia won the last two, including the last, which was in the Malaysian Masters.
So, you will choose.
Saved two match points before they won 23-21 in the deciding game. So, the Malaysians have won the top of the coin and have chosen end, and they wish to start the near side of the court. Well, exactly 1 year ago at the Indonesian Open, Rambitan suffered an ACL injury. He decided not to have the operation, and he's just made his way back. And here they are in the semi-final. What a return after their recent gold medal at the Southeast Asian Games. This is Pramudia Kusumawardana. He's 22 years of age from Sukabumi in West Java. 173, he's 5'8", and because of the injury problems to his partner, they are way down from their career high of 11. Hiramir Eric Yucha Jakob Rambitan, and you'll forgive us if we just refer to him as Rambitan after the full introduction. 23 years of age, from Depok in West Java, part of the Jakarta metropolitan area. He's the taller of the two at 5'9", and they beat Ben Lane and Sean Bendy in the first round. Second round against the three-time former finalists and former champions Hassan and Setiawan. Quarter final against Yang Wei Keng and Wang Chang. They were 11-17 down in the deciding game, up to 110 of the last 12 points to book their place in this semi-final. Aaron Chia is 26 years of age from the ancient city of Malacca, and he and his partner went up one place on the world rankings to three, but did spend a total of 16 weeks across two different spells at number two on the world rankings. It is their second consecutive semi-final at the Indonesia Open. A year ago, they lost to the eventual champion, Yu Chen Ushuani. So we eke his 25 years of age from the Malaysian capital of Kuala Lumpur, the taller of the two. In the first round, they beat last year's All England champions, Fitri and Molana. In the second round, they beat the beaten finalists from last year here at the Indonesia Open. And in the quarterfinal, beat Koga and Sotai, Saito from Japan. All their matches in two straight games. They've looked very impressive so far, the Malaysians. So Iris Metpalu of Estonia is our umpire for this one, and Simon Au from Hong Kong, China, our service judge. Sanayan is rocking.
Ladies and gentlemen. On my right, Jeremiah Eric Yoche, Jakob Rambitan, and Pramudya Kusumawardana, Indonesia. And on my left, Aaron Chia and Soboyik, Malaysia. Jeremiah Eric Yoche, Jakob Rambitan to serve to Soboyik. Lavo. Play.
So the Indonesians, unseeded pair of Kusumawardana and Rambitan, far side of the court against the reigning world champions from Malaysia, Aaron Chia.
Service over, one love.
Service error from Aaron Chia. Kusumawardana just saying to the umpire, I can't hear for the cheers. Can't hear you calling. Beautiful.
Brilliant shot, yeah.
Aaron Carr finding a very acute angle.
And the crowd here is, I mean, to say it's electric would be an understatement.
Service fault is called.
Too high.
Called an Aaron Chia.
Service over. 4-3.
Well, you didn't get called once yesterday.
Five, three.
6-3 in the first. It feels like it's 19 all in the third after like 2 hours, the way that the crowd is. And I do think that is going to have an effect on the Malaysians. Just going to increase the pressure on them.
Well, for those of you that don't remember the Indonesian Open last year, in the quarterfinal stage, Rambitan and Kusumawardana were 20-17 up in the deciding game in the quarterfinal stage against their opponents of today. And it was at that stage that Rambitan injured his ACL. And he stayed on court and tried desperately to win the final point.
At the moment, the crowd is, you know, they're turning the two Indonesian lads into gold, and everything they're doing is perfect.
Service over. 4-9.
I thought Rambitan just flipped.
Yeah, and it was out.
Yeah, but then he's gone on the right. If they were on 9, he should have been on the left.
Yeah. The umpire should have left it.
Five,
it the wrong
six,
way around then.
Nine.
Malaysians made a service error, and Aaron Shah has also been faulted for an illegal serve.
Five, 11-5
the advantage to the unseeded Indonesian against the reigning world champion, Kusumawardana and Rambitan. A 6-point advantage, 11-5 at mid-game interval. Kusumawardana.
12.
The way they're playing at the moment, you know, don't get me wrong, they are a great pair, but the way they're playing at the moment, they're playing above their level. They're playing like, you know, almost like badminton gods. They're doing everything right. It's just, you know, everything. It's just magic.
I think we should remember that before Rambitan's injury, they did win the Asian Championships, beating their opponents of today, the now world champions, in the final.
Yeah, they are a great pair, you know, and but the way they're doing at the moment, it's like everything's gold. Every shot choice is, okay, we've had one maybe that wasn't quite right, but almost everything else, the shot choice has been right, the shot selection, the movement, everything has been perfect. They're making the Malaysians look quite average, but as you identified, Jill, the Malaysians in this tournament have been incredible. It's been the form that we saw before when, you know, they won the World Championship.
Yeah.
6.
This is a phenomenal start by Kusumawardana and Rambitan.
Oh, I'm not sure about
that. Service over. 7-14.
Got to do more of that, get themselves on the attack. They've been reactive rather than proactive. So
yeah,
far.
Yeah, I would agree with that too. Now are looking so rattled.
Just missed it.
Yeah.
Service over.
But the quality on almost every single shot from the Indonesians
17.
At the moment is right at the top end of the scale. I mean, he's missed that by kind of an inch maybe, otherwise it would be absolutely perfect.
At the moment,
service over.
The Malaysians
18,
look like rabbits caught in the headlights.
Service over. 10,
I would say it's integral for the Malaysians before this game ends that they've settled, because the amount of mistakes that we've seen, the unforced errors from them, is just too many for a pair of their calibre.
Good return of serve from Aaron Chia.
11-19.
Opportunities for the Indonesians.
Okay.
Well, served before the umpire was ready.
I think it's a difficult
first
one here, yeah, because all the players appear to be ready, and I'm going to be honest, no one can hear the umpire. It's just too loud.
21-12.
Opening game. You see, the umpire had raised her hand. Now, if she raises her hand, she really ought to bring the players back. Play the point again.
Yeah, you're right. I think because all the players are ready, she let it go just because it's a unique situation, but you're exactly right, Jill.
In favour of Kusumawardana and Rambitan.
Thank you.
20 seconds.
I have to say the crowd here is so infectious. I mean, I've got goosebumps when I'm not playing. It is such an incredible atmosphere.
So get ready.
So the Indonesian pair of Kusumawardana and Rambitan.
Level.
One game to the group against the reigning world champions.
Court.
Nice play from Aaron Chia. That's
so
what the Malaysians have got to do. They've got to get him
one
forward.
Love.
And dominating the front court area.
And that's a shot all the Indonesians are so good at, and the skill level needed to stop this off. Steps in, stops it off to perfection.
Yeah, it's a beauty.
You can see how deep the Malaysians are defending there as well.
Well, as far as Malaysia is concerned, it's been 15 years since they had a men's double pair in the final here. Of the Indonesian Open. Mohamed Zakri Abdul-Latif, Mohamed Farizi Suwan, Mohamed Pazari actually won the
Service
title 15
over.
Years ago.
2-1.
I think the world champions are going to have to up their game if they want to be in the final tomorrow.
Service vault called. Service over, 2-4.
Too high. I find it extraordinary that I've seen Aaron Char and Sawik all tournaments, and I certainly called them out yesterday. Didn't get called once, I don't think.
Service over, 3-2.
I beg your pardon, Aaron Char got faulted once. Oh, that has been wide. Well played by Tony.
4-2.
The Malaysians have settled much better in this second game. They're starting to find their level now. Putting a lot more pressure on the Indonesians, and now just a few of the wrong shots are coming, as in shot choice, shot selection. We didn't really see that in the first, because the Indonesians were flowing, everything was going so good. Absolutely amazing, but he's so calm and he's so kind of focused on just one thing. Quite bold.
Four, six. Service over. 7-4.
Brilliant defence. Just the long shot they've got to lift that.
8-4.
So Ruyik all over the net there. There's no space to play that net shot. Oh. Yeah, really long.
9-4.
Really good play. And throw at the net there. I mean, we've not really had a rally, or we've had a few, but not many at all in this match.
Good flick serve from Rambitan.
Wow.
Oh! Sensational! What an interception!
6-9.
Look at that!
Yeah, that's incredible. Full stretch and how he played at that speed.
Only
1 point in it now.
And you can just feel everything building. And any soft shot now becomes a bit more complicated, because when you get tense, when the pressure builds, your arm just gets tense and you just lose that ability to have the control. Brilliant smash from Chia.
Service over. 10-9. Service over.
And this crowd now is, they're so involved in the match.
Good return. 11-10.
Then easy
away.
So, just that solitary point in it. At the mid-game interval here in the second game. The advantage is the Malaysians.
Players back on court. court.
I think the outcome of this is all going to be about character and nerve.
Service over.
The world champions need to dig deep and show their character. Yeah, because they're not just playing two opponents.
Service over.
They've got the 12, whole 11. Crowd. Contend with as well.
Yeah, and I think if you're not in this hall, you can't understand how big an effect the crowd's having.
Well, 13-11.
I can't believe how quickly this is going. 25 minutes this match has been in progress.
I think we had 25 minutes for one game of the ladies' doubles. Kusumawardana, for me, has always been the net man. He's always the one who's chasing forward, and it's Rambitan with the power at the back. But the way they're playing today is actually the reversal of that.
Yeah, and I think that since his injury, it has been a reversal of that. Yeah, he can't move to the round the head position. Rambitan. We were noticing that
service
yesterday.
Service over.
Well, 14, he points to the corner 12. And asks his coaches whether he should have played it or whether it would have gone out. I think it was weighing.
Yeah, I agree with you. I do think it was in. I think it made us a misjudgment. Got his feet wrong and kind of got himself trapped.
Court on the return of serve. Delight the home fan.
14.
Just missed it, I think. Just flipped his frame.
15-13.
Rambitan made the right move there. 13. Just snatched just a fraction at it.
Well, they've made incredible comebacks, both last week in Singapore in a game and 11-2 down against Astrup and Rasmussen. And then in the quarterfinal yesterday.
Service over.
Against Yang Weiqing at 14. 11-17 down in the deciding game, winning 10 of the last 12 points. So there's no doubt that Kusumawardana and Rambitan can come back from this deficit.
15-16.
Back level.
16-all, change.
It's quite incredible. The Indonesians are so focused on a style of play that they're following it to a T, and they're playing at times incredible.
And you have to be sure that the other one is ready as well. You have to be sure that the other one is ready, okay? You can't serve before, okay?
Well, in Sorry, I couldn't hear what the umpire was saying there at all.
Service over, 17-16.
I think you're just instructing, you can only serve when your opponent's actually kind of watching, if they're ready.
That's
a great interception by Cho.
Look at his movement around the head.
So he can't recover at all.
He can't recover at all. Rambitan.
I do feel this is one of the reasons why he's been so bold and so kind of confident in what he's doing, because if he doesn't do that, he knows he can't win playing a different style.
Point advantage for the number two seeds and 2 points away from taking this second game.
Rambitan was stretched twice.
Service
there,
over.
And there was one before, and the quality
18,
of his shot
19.
Was like incredible, considering how balanced he was and how stretched
on
he
court.
Was.
So?
And if this gets to 19 all, wow, the atmosphere is going to explode in here, and the pressure is just going to build.
A game point or a match point. Defence across court into the open space. And 20 all, and extra points will be required until the clear 2 point winning margin. Longest rally of the match. I'm not surprised, 50 shots. It's not a particularly long rally as far as semi-final day has been concerned.
Thank you.
But the enormity of the point.
On court.
the tension within the rally.
Please.
Yeah, what a point that was. Thing is, now is integral because we've had a rally that was phenomenal. They had everything, and we now had a short pause.
20 all.
Both pairs need to switch on, so it's not a quick, short, sharp rally for one of them to lose.
Rambitan.
21.
And having
20.
Survived a match point opportunity, now the Malaysians, Arantar and Soeik, have a game point opportunity to send this to a decider.
Yeah, and in that rally, you can tell the coaches are now telling him, and Rambitan couldn't have taken that last one. He did everything right before that. He put the pressure on. They got the short lift, but he was chasing forward. You've got to let your partner take that one.
This time, his timing was perfect.
This is turning into an absolutely incredible game.
21-all, very quick. Jeremiah, this is not quick. Back on court. Thank you.
Yeah, he really does struggle when landing on that left leg. Jeremiah Rambitan.
Play.
21-all. Who's got the nerve? That's brilliantly
service
played
over
from Soeik.
22,
and it's a
21.
Second game point opportunity now for the number two seeds.
Great return, looked off. Brilliant shot.
One game all, 23-21, the second game, the world champion from Malaysia.
21. One game all.
One game all confirms the umpire. Only 37 minutes for the first two games. Very quick rallies. When it is one game all, the Malaysians surviving at that point. We're going to be treated to a third and deciding game.
Twenty seconds. So, back on court. So.
So what drama and what excitement. The world champion Rowan Chia and Paul Reeves dividing a match point opportunity in that second game. And straight through 23-21 to force a third and deciding game against Kusumawardana and the Rambitan. Indonesians have to be awfully careful here because there's a danger that they will feel that the bubble has burst and that missed their opportunity. They have to stick to their resolve.
Service over.
Stick to the game plan.
Totally agree with you, Jill. Sometimes when you almost touch victory and then it gets snatched from you, it can be so hard. But the way they started the third game, they started it calm and composed.
Service over. 2-2.
If I was the Malaysians, I would be doing all I could to try and stretch, turn, twist, Rambitan. Did you get that? Brilliant.
Three,
great defense.
2.
Yeah. Two flicks to him already.
4-2.
Yeah, gets a pat on the back from his partner.
So he's had a great start to this third game. And again, 3 out of 3.
6-2.
Yeah.
Too late. 6-2. Too late.
Yep. Quite right. Good umpiring.
I think something
seven,
was working so well
three.
Previously from the Indonesians was the pressure that they were putting on the Malaysians, but now the Malaysians are ready. Anytime the shuttle's going up, Malaysians are ready for power coming at them, and then they're just turning at the other side, exposing the Indonesians.
Chavis fault called.
Yeah, they fault called again on Aaron Sharp.
Service over. 4-7. Play. Service over, 8-4.
Yeah, so this final game has been pretty much perfect from him so far.
Fault.
Well, my fear about
nine,
the bubble bursting.
9-4.
Looks he's not that as though it may be coming through.
And again, 4 out of 4.
Service over.
Well, the Indonesians have proved over the last couple of weeks that they have claimed to be called the comeback kings. I don't like them off yet.
And that's gone service well over. Off the back line.
10-5.
He does not look comfortable when hitting from that round the head position here in the Rambitan.
Yeah, I just really, really hope there's not a big issue with the ACL. I just hope maybe it's a little bit of inflammation that's just pinching or something like that.
No, he's been like that ever since he's come back. It's an issue. 11-5, the Malaysians lead. That's a mid-game interval on the 10th race in the third of the final game. Kusumawardana, right shoulder, and it appears
players on court.
As well.
Jeremiah on court.
Rambitan reapplying his knee support as well. The advantage in the deciding game to the world champion.
Service over.
A third service error from 11. Aaron Chia.
Is he overthinking it a little bit just because he's been called quite a few times?
Court. Service over. 12-6.
Looks a little deflated to me.
Yeah, I would agree. I would say first game, the Indonesians were like a 15 out of 10, they were that good. And the second game, it just got snatched from them. And this final game, they're starting to look deflated, as you said.
Service over, 7-13.
Rambitan.
Yeah.
That's gone long at the back line.
14,
position at the front
eight.
Of the court.
Yeah.
rallies like that, you just keep giving the Indonesians the lead. I would say Rambitan, the way he's watching it. He is looking in pain.
I think he's looking fine.
Play. Rambitan to the front of the court as much as possible, and I can tell you as we look at the fans, Rambitan, after the longest rally of the match, 59 shots, was bent double. That is a definite sign of fatigue. Look at it. Players
look
back
at it.
On court.
Point. That has a 7-point advantage on stage. Yeah, it was all too obvious that he was going to take third.
Yeah, it was too quick.
11-15.
Rambitan could feel it, and then he moved perfectly. Beginning of the third, it was working so well on the flick because it was a bit calmer, more controlled, less obvious.
And he's hitting with the drift now, so he's got to be very cautious. He doesn't hit long, and that was probably short.
Service over. 16-11.
So, the umpire has called for the referee. When the umpire raises his or her right arm, it means that they want the referee, and in this case, the medic. And when they raise their left arm, it's for a challenge.
Yeah, I think it's Aaron's shoulder.
I remember this scoreline that the Indonesians were down in their quarterfinal yesterday in the deciding game. They've got a draw on that experience now.
18-11.
Believe in it.
Quick. Thank you.
going wide.
13-18.
Surely they couldn't do it again, could they?
Service
the
over.
Is unlikely now.
19-13. Very
2 points needed by the number two seeds to book their place in a third Super 1000 for this final. It's inside the back line. It is match point opportunity. So the Indonesians have asked for a challenge. I believe this is the first challenge in the entirety of the match. I saw that as clearly in. It was clearly in.
Challenge unsuccessful.
So match point
one
opportunity
remaining
for the world champions, Aaron Carr.
20. Match point 13. Play.
And they've done it. The world champions have come from a game deficit to beat Kusumawardana and Rambitan. 21-13 in the deciding game, having saved a match point in the second game. Came back from the brink, and tomorrow they have a chance of winning their first ever World Tour title.
Match won by Aaron Chia and Sobo Yik, 12-21, 23-21, 21-13.
3 minutes shy of the hour mark for the victory. Coming from that point down. Confirmation of the scoreline, 12-21, 23-21, 21-13 in the decided game in a match lasting 57 minutes. Coming up next is our last semi-final. It's the All England champion Lee Hsien-Fung up against Anthony Sinisuka-Ginty, the Olympic bronze medalist. Welcome back to Istora Senayan, iconic badminton venue. the Indonesian fans. So passionate, so vocal, and so knowledgeable about the sport of badminton. Well, they'll be looking forward to this last semi-final because